Not too close, not too far.
No. Good distance.
Yeah.
15 seconds.
Hello, and welcome to Decades, the show that tests the reach of millennial knowledge. I'm your host, Kofi, and let's see who we have competing today. Contestant number one, what's your name and where are you from?
My name's Jonas, and I'm from Fort Myers, Florida.
All right, Jonas, nice to meet you. Contestant two.
My name is Sydney from Miami, Florida.
Sydney, also nice to meet you as well. So, here at Decades, we test the limit of millennial knowledge. So we're gonna have rounds where we're going to go back from the 2010s back to the 1950s. Each round, the points will increase and will get a little bit tougher. So let's see how much you guys know about the decades. So we're going to start with the 2010s. Okay, question number one will be a pop culture question. So in 2014, this former SNL cast member and stand-up comedian took over The Tonight Show.
Oh.
Seth Meyers.
No. Sydney?
Just gonna go with Seth.
The answer is Jimmy Kimmel.
Oh, yeah. That's...
All right, so next our news question. In 2012, this fast food chain set off a string of protests after its CEO said he supported only a traditional marriage. Sydney.
Is it Chick-fil-A?
Chick-fil-A is correct.
Okay.
All right, so now we'll be moving into the early 2000s. All right, you guys ready?
Yeah.
All right, so in 2009, the H1N1 influenza strain was declared a global pandemic by the World Health Organization. What's its more commonly known name? Jonas.
Swine flu.
It is the swine flu, correct.
Competing. I was like, go ahead.
Pop culture. This expressive musical genre broke into mainstream culture in the early 2000s with the platinum-selling success of bands Jimmy Eat World and Dashboard Confessional. Jonas.
Pop punk?
No. Sydney?
I can tell ya.
We're looking for emo.
Emo.
All right. So next we'll be moving to the 1990s.
Woo.
All right, so we're back in the 1990s. Let's do it. We'll start with the pop culture question. Spanish pop group Los Del Rio had the nation dancing with this song in 1994. Even then, Vice President Al Gore had to show off his moves at the 1995 Democratic National Convention. Jonas.
La Bamba.
No. Sydney. No?
No.
1990s, y'all, the Macarena.
Oh.
Come on, Macarena. All right, let's do it. All right, news question. Which American multinational technology company specializing in internet-related services and products was founded in 1998 and gets its name from a misspelling of the word that means the number one followed by 100 zeros? Don't all jump at once. Who got it? Jonas.
Microsoft?
No.
Okay.
Go.
Go ahead.
Sydney?
That's all you
You
want
to go for it? All right. The answer is Google. Google.
Yeah. Google.
All right. Okay, so we're moving to the 1980s, guys. Okay, 1980s. In 1983, the first mobile phones were introduced to the public by what company? Jonas.
T-Mobile.
T-Mobile is incorrect. Sydney, chance to steal.
Metro PCS.
No. Good one, though. No, the answer is Motorola. Motorola.
Oh, the Razor?
Motorola.
What was the question?
All right, pop culture. What was the nickname of given to a group of young actors who frequently appeared together in teen-oriented coming-of-age films in the 1980s? Jonas.
Rat Pack.
No. Sydney.
Does not have an answer.
Sydney does not have an answer. The Brat Pack is what we're looking. Very close. Very close. They're very close. You almost knew that. So that's cool. All right. So that's our first round. So let's check in with our co-host Anna to see how many points our contestants have.
All right. We have Jonas in the lead with 10 points and Sydney with 5 points.
All right. All right, good, good, good. All right, thanks, Anna. So we'll be back with 70s trivia after a short break. Stay tuned.
First day of the challenge, feeling hyped, feeling good after a nice back day. That's what it's used to say, which are back days. Hopefully, this will continue. Feeling weird today. Didn't do any cardio at the legs. Don't skip leg day. Hopefully, I'll get used to this. The shoulders and arms, you can see I got a nice pump going. Feeling confident, I'm doing this. Haven't gone down in reps yet. Hopefully that stays the same. Day four is chest day. I felt awkward today. I did one less rep of 185. Today, I'm feeling pretty normal, just did arms, so cardio is not really a big factor in doing arms. I've been doing cardio for months now and cutting it off is starting to kick in. After deadlifts, I was dead. I couldn't do anything else. I'm happy that the challenge is over.
All right, welcome back to Decades. Again, I'm your host, Kofi, and before we get into the 1970s, I just want to hear a little bit of, from the contestants. So, contestants, if you could travel to any decade for a day, what would it be, Jonas?
For a day, I'd probably say, like, early 70s, late 60s.
Early 70s? Any particular reason?
I like the idea of, like, Woodstock, Summer of Love. Seems like a fun time.
Ah, yeah, Flower Child. Got you, got you, got you. Sydney?
Probably the Roaring 20s.
Roaring 20s, interesting. Why is that?
I just think it was a great, well, not for everyone, but in general, a great time, a festive time to be around. So.
Interesting. The Roaring 20s. Okay, yeah. I think I'm with Jonas, man. I'd like to see that hippie culture up close, you know? Woodstock and love and all of that. Okay, so let's go back to the 70s, guys. Let's do it. Okay, so in news, starting January 2nd, 1971, which product was banned from television and radio advertising? Jonas.
Cigarettes.
Cigarettes is correct. Cigarette advertising was banned after Congress passed the Public Health Cigarette Smoking Act. Okay, in pop culture, this television series had a person who was the epitome of cool. One snap of his fingers and girls would magically appear. What's the name of the television series? Jonas?
Happy Days?
Happy Days. Happy Days is correct. All right. Jonas. All right, so we're moving into the 1960s. Now, again, Sydney, you have a chance to come back now.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll get there.
We got three more. We got three more decades. Two more decades to go. Okay. All right. Okay. So let's start with pop culture. All right. So, pop culture, 1960s. Which animated series starring modern Stone Age cavemen was first aired in 1960s and ran six seasons? Sydney.
Is it the Flintstones?
It was the Flintstones. It was the Flintstones.
Look at that comeback.
Sydney on the comeback trail, y'all. Watch out. Okay. Okay. This could do it for you. News, 1960s. In 1960, which two candidates participated in the first presidential debate aired on television?
Oh, I do know that. Oh, I just cursed.
No? Okay, guys, time's up. I'm sorry. The answer is Richard Nixon and John F. Kennedy. Okay. So, sadly, we're moving on to our last decade. Before you guys face off in the speed round. You guys ready for the 1950s?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Okay. So 1950s, we're going to wait for the music. Okay. So we're back. 1950s. You guys ready?
Yes.
Okay. Let's start with the news. Get that out the way. What war between parts of an Asian country took place in the 1950s?
One Asian country.
Are we one Asian country?
So like a civil war.
You have a guess? I'm sorry guys, the time is up. The Korean War. The Korean War took place between 1950 and 1953. Fought between North and South Korea. Yeah. Moving on to pop culture. What were the most common colors for saddle shoes?
Brown.
Sorry, Sydney, no. Jonas?
Black.
We'll take that.
Okay.
Black and white. Black and white. Black and white were the most common colors for saddle shoes worn with poodle skirts. Okay, so we're going to check in with our co-host Anna for our scores.
All right, we have Jonas in the lead still with 120 points and Sydney with 45.
Okay, so we're going to move into our speed round. Sydney, you still have a chance to come back. Our speed round questions are worth 5 points each. And if you take them all, it still might mathematically be a chance you can come back.
Possibly.
I don't know. We're going to check in with Anna to see about that.
Okay.
We're going to check in with Anna to see about that. So we're going to go to commercial break and be right back with our speed round. I was going to say 10, but then... There's 770 plus.
My Fitbit Alter right here.
Whoa.
So far so good. I went to an exercise class this morning, which is great. And I just walked home from work in the rain.
Walked 18,000 steps or 7.2 miles today. So I'm feeling really, really good.
It's not even 1 p.m. and my Fitbit told me that I already hit my step goal for today. So it's pretty awesome. I just went to a high intensity interval training class with my Fitbit, of course. I've been sitting a lot today, so I'm really glad I went to the gym. I haven't been moving a lot, but my Fitbit has this feature where if I don't get 250 steps in an hour, it'll buzz and tell me to move. While I was running, I hit my daily step goal. So another great day, feeling pretty good. And this week has gone really fast, but my Fitbit definitely helped motivate me, especially when I saw that I hadn't moved much or when I was really close to my goal.
Okay, so welcome back to Decades. Now, we're about to go into our speed round, and this is how it works. Now, I'll ask the first question to the contestant with the highest points. In this case, that'll be you, Jonas. and you're going to keep answering until you get one wrong. If you do, the question will go to your opponent, Sydney, here, and keep answering until they get it wrong. If they get it wrong, then it'll go back to you, and so on and so forth. Now, each question in this round is going to be worth 10 points. We're going to ask 10 questions. So, Sydney, you have a chance.
I have a chance. All
you
right.
You have a chance. Okay. We're ready. Let's do it. Now. Wait a minute. Okay. Ken Jennings, a contestant on which popular quiz show, won over $2.5 million in 2004?
Jeopardy.
Jeopardy is correct. Question two. What was the family name of the main characters in The Cosby Show, which ran from 1984 to 1992?
Don't know.
The family name. Yeah. Okay, that would be the Huxtable family. All right, moving back to Jonas. Which popular children's show debuted on PBS in 1969?
Sesame Street.
Sesame Street is correct. Question number four. The popular show American Bandstand started in 1952 and was hosted by whom? Jonas?
No idea.
The popular American Bandstand show started in 1952 and was hosted by whom?
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay, the answer is Dick Clark. Question number five. Which popular 1990s TV series that ran from 1994 to 2004 featured characters named Rachel, Monica, Phoebe, Joey, Chandler, and Ross?
That'd be Friends.
That would be Friends. Question number six. Which controversial but popular television show that ran from 1971 to 1979 featured a working class bigoted head of household? Almost. The clue, Sydney.
The clue is Arch.
Archie's like the main character.
Unfortunately, the answer is All in the Family. All in the Family. Okay, question number seven. Which U.S. soap opera first aired on CBS in 1956?
General Hospital.
That is incorrect. Sydney.
A soap opera, All My Children.
We're looking for As the World Turns. As the World Turns. Okay. Question number eight. Which cartoon television show based on the Griffin family became popular in the early 2000s?
Family Guy.
That would be Family Guy. That would be Family Guy. Question number nine. Which 1960s show featured a talking horse owned by Wilbur Post?
I don't know.
Sydney.
I do not know.
Mr. Ed, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Ed is what we're looking for. And our final question. What was the name of the character, what was the name of the charter boat that shipwrecked in the 1960s show Gilligan's Island?
Oh, God. I don't know.
I'm sorry, Jonas, Sydney.
Have no clue.
No, the answer is the SS Minnow. The SS Minnow, and that is it for our speed round, and our winner today is Jonas. Let's give him a hand. Let's give him a hand. Let's give him a hand. All right. Congratulations, Jonas. You have just won Decade. Your prize is a Coca-Cola Classic and some M&Ms. Congratulations to you. All right. Don't eat it all in one place. And our runner-up, we have some Lucky Charms for you.
Thank you so much.
Please enjoy with the milk of your choice. Take it home and have fun. Thank you all for joining us for another episode of Decades.